In today's video, we're going to talk about vet office etiquette. And I think this is something that we really don't talk about a lot, or at least me, because I've never made a video about it. So I go to the vet's office with Max, my big German Shepherd, who is not dog friendly. This guy, Whiskey, loves everybody and other dogs, but Max not so much. So we're in the vet's office, Max isn't feeling well, he's sitting right next to me, perfectly, he's totally okay. A lady walks in, her dog is dragging her, literally, on the lead, just dragging her across the room. And she's like, it's okay, my dog is great with other dogs. That's a really bad assumption because she's trying to excuse her dog's bad behavior by saying it's social. But what she doesn't understand is that my dog is not dog social at all. So I back him up about 8 feet. Max is in a sit, he's in a sit stay basically. He's calm, he's fine. And I ask her, can you give us some space? My dog is not great with other dogs. And it just led me to think, why is it that humans want their dogs to meet other dogs all the time? Like, it's not okay. At a vet's office, it's not okay. One, dogs go to the vet's office because they're sick. So if a dog is sick, why would you want your dog to meet it? Second of all, if the dog isn't feeling well, chances are it's stressed out a lot. Sorry, we're shooting this outside, got a lot of cars. Chances are if it's at the vet's, it's stressed out, it's not feeling well, you're just asking for a dog fight, or you're asking to get your dog sick, which I know you don't wanna do. From a behavior standpoint, socializing dogs in a confined like place like that is never okay, okay? Dogs, there's thousands of smells, females in heat that have gone through there, other dogs. I mean, it's just like a plethora of smells for a dog. It arouses them, and you don't really want your dogs to meet in that arousal type state of mind. So from a behavior standpoint and a health standpoint, guys, it's not okay. Don't let your dogs meet other dogs. Find a quiet spot in the office and wait your turn. And if someone comes over and their dog's all bouncy, just say, hey, you know what? Can we have some space? I'm sorry. And then go to another spot. Don't let them meet because it's not really great for your dog and it's not good for their dog, whether they know it or not, or whether they understand this concept. And I'll tell you, I go back that day to pick up my German Shepherd. We had to leave him there. And it's in the evening time. And I'm just sitting here, just dumbfounded, sitting in the waiting room, waiting. And a guy is sitting right on the chair, about five chairs down from me. He's got about a 50-pound dog sitting in the chair next to him. And this guy walks in, he has two dogs on a lead, and guess what they're doing? They're pulling and yanking them. They go right over there, and before that guy could even blink, those two dogs are smelling that dog, a fight broke out, and it was awful, right? All that could have been prevented. And someone might say, well, my dog pulls on a lead. Well, learn how to walk your dog on a lead. It's not okay. If I were to go into a hospital, I wouldn't run around high-fiving people and chest bumping them and saying, oh my gosh, hey, it's great to see ya. You kind of don't do that, right? Like if you go to the ER, which I hope you don't, but you're kind of to yourself, and that's how it should be at a vet. So this is a quick reminder, keep you and your dog to yourself to prevent any sicknesses or health problems, and also from any behavior problems. So there you go. Guys, listen to me. It'll be bad if you don't. Or you could learn the hard way, which would be a fight or your dog gets sick, which you don't want that. Your dog doesn't want that. We'll see you guys in the next video.